Aquaman number 11, written by Jeff Johns, art by Ivan Reyes. Last issue left off with Black Manta getting, I think, two, maybe three of the relic things, and then teleporting into Mera and Dr. Shin. This issue picks up 6 years ago, flashback to them getting the relic things. And they apparently were originally located in the first king of Atlantis's tomb. And nobody even remembers his name, but they call him the Dead King. And everyone's like, oh, wow, okay, so you're here for your heritage? And Aquaman's like, no, Black Manta's after these things. They're bait. And they're like, could you care so little about this? And he's like, let me tell you a story. When it came to the Dead King, he had the ability to escape, and he had, like, the power to do so when Atlantis came crashing down. But instead, he went into the city searching for his wife and children. He didn't find them, and he died. So really, how much is this power really worth? But either way, they each get an object, and Aquaman gets the trident. So then we cut back to today, and they, of course, lost Black Manta. He just teleported away. But the prisoner of war guy shows up, and he's like, hey... Or no, the operative, sorry. He shows up and he's like, hey, I know where Black Manta's going. Cut to where Black Manta is, and Mera is currently trying to beat the ever-loving crap out of him. And she, of course, has her hydrokinesis and is trying to basically drain the water from his body, to which Black Manta reveals that something in his suit allows that to not happen because she needs to be in contact with the moisture, I guess. Regardless, he manages to shock her, send her out of her way, and then steal Dr. Shin, teleporting out. So right now we've got a plane ride going on, and Operative recovers. He's got his map out, and he's like, all right, I got this from Black Manta safe. They were looking through a whole bunch of stuff, but they basically was a map that he thought was going to lead to the seventh Atlantean relic. And they're like, there's not a seventh one. We went to the tomb. We got them all. And it's like, well, Black Manta thinks there's seven. So clearly he's going back there. And then Operative's... son, grandson, whoever it is, shows up and is like, wow, you're really Aquaman. And then immediately something, red alerts start going off, and we see that the final member of the team, because prisoner is already on the plane, the final member shows up, and it's Vostok, who's wearing this golden mask thing. And he lands, and he's like, hey, sorry, I haven't spoken in 2 years. How's it going, everybody? And apparently he's just been living on the moon. Because sure, why not? But anyway, as soon as he gets there, Aquaman immediately is like, hey, yeah, one of our members is dead, and leave the door open, I'm leaving. And they say like, hey, we're part of a team here. We can do this as a team. And it's like, no, Black Manta's after me. I'm putting you all at risk just by you being around me. Like, it's important that I do this on my own. And then we get this whole, like, backstory on Prisoner and Vostok, because I guess... we didn't get that enough before. And Prisoner's like, no, you need to have people. I don't have anyone. I lost everyone. I'm so alone. And then Vostok steps up and he's like, hey, you know the reason that, like, I went to the moon? Like, I didn't have anything in my life. And then I joined your guys' team and we had friends. And then we split up. And then I just was waiting on the moon for you to eventually call me. And he just really wants to be part of a team again. To which Arthur says, like, cool, bye. And then he just leaves. And he jumps off the plane. And, of course, he hits the water and he immediately starts taking off towards the tomb of the Atlantean king. And they're like, well, he can swim faster than we can fly, but we can at least try to keep up with him. But then they're like, no, no, no. We shouldn't be going there because here's the thing. There's someone he will listen to. We got to go get Mera. So they're flying out to go get Mera to try to talk some sense to Arthur. Meanwhile, at the tomb, Black Manta has already arrived when Aquaman gets there. And they're looking around. He's got all this search crew and goons looking for the seventh relic. And Dr. Shin is there, and he's like, all right, Dr. Shin, tell me how to get the relic. And he's like, I will rather die than try to betray Arthur again. And finally, as soon as he says that, one of the goons steps up and is just like, hey, turns out if you use two of them at the same time, it triangulates and shows you where the last one is. So they use two of the relics and everything starts glowing and they're like, oh, of course, the last relic was underneath the tomb. So Black Manta breaks it open and gets the Scepter of the Dead King, a.k.a. the seventh relic, a.k.a. the thing he can use, it's a weapon that was used to sink Atlantis. It's literally the thing that sank Atlantis, and now Black Manta has it. That's where we leave off. I like it. I really do. That little middle section, though, in terms of, like, oh, we have to have this whole thing on why Prisoner and Volstagg all feel alone. Like, that sagged. That really did. It wasn't a... It was just them talking and just them... Don't get me wrong. Prisoner, like, I got that part of the story. But Volstagg just showed up. So this was just his time to shine. And I think it was done very well. Because he hasn't spoken in 2 years, like, and these are his very close friends in his eyes, it was done emotionally. However, because they put it in the middle of this bit of everyone saying the importance of friendship, it just kind of fell a little bit flat. It was just a bit of like, okay, yeah, no, totally. The power of love, guys. The power of love. So it's good. I don't want to say it's not good. It definitely is. It's been keeping up with everything that's been going on so far. But this one definitely did feel like okay, we just need to show that Aquaman still has trouble working in, like, a team environment, I guess, especially when Black Manta's involved. And to do that, they had to kind of make him a dick. But regardless, it's okay. I would give it a... I give it a 7. It's okay. It's good. It's fine. But it's not great. And I think there are great parts to it, but it's just counterbalanced by the parts that are like, okay, and moving on. So 7 for this. And I think there's only one more issue in the arc, so we'll see how that wraps up next time.